Hi everybody, this is Al Spath. Positive Poker Insiders is on the air today, and I'm over at full flush and picked up pocket aces in the big blind. I'm going to raise this up to $2. See if I can get this guy the first raise to go in. I'm on a challenge table today where I took $10 and I'm trying to get to $35. I do have the redraw here. So it'd be very interesting. This could be the first hand that I really lose here at this table. Got a quick call there. Got two pair now. I'm definitely going to bet this and see if I can get him all in here. And I guess the rest is history, right? Well, we didn't get him to call, but we sure did make a pot, and we reached our $35. I was here for about 20 minutes. I've been playing a different style this morning. I don't know if Posse will come in and he'll testify to that, but I've been playing a completely different style here this morning. I don't have that much money on full flush, and I wanted to run it up. Oh, I'm out of position here. I'm going to take a chance just on this one, just running hot right here. I'm going to put this in, hope this guy here doesn't raise, and hope I hit. Boy, I could have hit two deuces there. I would have been in great shape. Normally on Sundays, we have the Sunday conversation, but today we don't have it. It's Easter. Yes, what am I doing working on Easter? But, you know, got to have some time for pleasure as well. Thought I'd just stream it for everybody. Started with $10 next to Posse. He had around $60 at the time. I didn't know if I could catch up to him or not, but there's always a possibility. Next week, we're going to have Noah Schwartz on. You all know about him and his exploits at the World Series of Poker and on TV and around the world and jet setter and poker player, and Filati's all in here, and you can have my 60 cents. He's gotten tired of me raising so much. I will be honest with you that I've received aces three times since I've been sitting here. Only once did I make a big hand like I just did. The other times I just raised and everybody folded, so they weren't that prosperous for me. Here he goes in all again. You don't usually see somebody unless they're on tilt, because you don't usually do that, and you also don't get cards like that that you waste. So I did achieve my goal already, and it was in less than an hour. But I just wanted to sit at the table and see if we can go a little further. So now $50 is the range that we want to get to. Following Noah Schwartz next week, we'll have Rich Muni, M-U-N-Y, and he's the guy in charge of the PPA, the Poker Players Alliance. And so that'll be interesting. If you got questions for him, be happy to take them on as well. Hi, Nick and Ryan, they're both in the house today. So far, it's early in the morning on Easter. It's 11 o'clock Eastern time. I'm your host, Al Spath, sitting here teach. Ryan, I sent you an email this morning with a suggestion for the page on our Twitch offline screen. We want to promote The Lango and also Posse 1972, because I know you guys have your own channels, which is good. Lucky enough to test out two tables yesterday. Got a new format, new overlay by Posse here. Ryan, he made one up for me and I tested it out. I had two cash tables, one at True Poker, one at Full Flush. The one at True I made money on, the one at Full Flush I didn't make money on, but that's okay. It was a test to see if I could take down a table and put a new table up and do all kinds of things like that. The only problem it is for me, because of my monitor not being probably big enough, it made the tables about this size right here. And it was hard with my trifocals, if that's what I wear, to see the tables. I could, but it just made them harder for me. So it was a strain for the hour or 2 hours that I was doing it. I don't know. The reason I had to make them small was so I could put on the side the chat screen so I could see what everybody was saying. If I didn't have to do that, or if I had another monitor, as Ryan would say, but even if I had another monitor, I wouldn't know how to do it anyhow. I got a raise and a re-raise. This guy's going to shove it, see? You got to remember what they've been doing lately. Jax is ahead. Jax is still ahead. Jax is going to win. Goodbye, Falati. Falodi, whatever his name is. Or reload it. Nick is from Baltimore. Oh, I always go blank on his name. Something Jumbo. Super Jumbo, I think it is. Super Jumbo or something like that. Kind of a take on Giant Shrimp. An oxymoron. Like military intelligence. Had a guy in here all week long, TL Townsend 52 or something, asking for cash game. Had it yesterday and he didn't show up, and having one today and not here yet. So, but I understand it's Easter. It got somebody coming into the table right now. This is going to be a fold for me today at this table. Then, no matter what he does, I'm going to fold it here. Slot play sat down over here. We have another new person sitting down over here. Good fold by me. Let's see a Posse with his big ace. Now, if Posse doesn't have the ace, if he has something like a pair of tens or kings or queens, he might just, yeah, he might just call and float it a little bit and then try to take it. But now this guy puts $5 in, like he's really serious. So unless Posse has the trips, I think it's all going in here, folks. Nope, not yet. I think Posse just lost. No, he didn't.
Wow.
Again, I like to play this hand, but playing a lot tighter, playing a little smarter here today. Posse thought he had the seven. There's no way I had him on the seven. I had him on ace queen. I had Posse yet. On a good hand there when he stayed. Either big slick or a big pair, and the king came. I thought maybe he even hit trips, and he was just not trying to scare Hoodbridge out of the way. Hoodbridge is echoing that in the chat, saying it was a bad turn with the king coming. He flopped two pair, which was the ace seven, and he was hoping that Posse indeed had the ace queen and only had the top pair. Give him credit. Some good thinking. Excuse the voice. Had a nice anniversary yesterday. Went to dinner last night. Oh, we got a little min raise here from Nasir, huh? Well, I don't want this guy in, so let's make it a little bit bigger. Nope, jumped right in. I'm gonna check this. Got a feeling I'm gonna get a $3 bet here from somebody. Love to see a red 10 come. I'd love to see him call. It's See, now I'm going to bet 2 for 8, 4 to 1, but my implied odds are really big. I really don't want the ace. A 10 of clubs would be okay, but I really want the 10 of hearts. Oh, it was red. This guy's going to jam a big bet. No. They both didn't bet. Very uncharacteristic. Let's try to steal it. I'm trying to tell them I got the 8, and they missed the draw. Which is just a bluff, folks. I could get caught real easy with two people that are very calling stations. But when they checked that card, I knew that that 8 couldn't help them. Sometimes you gotta stick it out there to see if you get cut off. What was the name of that person that had it cut off? Bobbick. We'll all remember that. Later this week, we hope to have Ryan do his fourth session of his apprentice program, the coaching streaming program. He's got a new client that he's going to be bringing in, and he's going to shadow and give him some, well, I doubt it's going to be at this particular site. It's going to be a different site because Nigel, his client, doesn't play full flush. So it'll probably be a different site, and you'll have to do it either on TeamViewer or some kind of a share the screen and fit it into the overlay. So I look forward to that. Once again, this is a challenge table today. Started with 10. The goal was to get to 35, which I've achieved. Whether I go back or not, the goal was met. Now the new goal is to get to 50. I only had $12 remaining on full flush. I've taken most of my money off. I've decided to just let it play out here, and if I win, I win. If I lose, I lose, and move over to the True Poker. And if you need an affiliate link for over there, just send me if you don't have an account, just send me an email, alspath@alspath.com. I'll send you the link. Maybe we can put the link up on our Twitch page permanently so that people can click on it and get that. I don't like this early raise here. I don't really respect the queen king that much here. I'm just gonna let it go. If I played it, I probably would raise with it because I don't like the call with it. And now I could continuation bet if I raised with it, but I'm thinking this guy's solid. He's either got a bigger, you know, an ace king, ace queen, or he's got a nice pair here, and he's gonna just rock the boat here with a dollar. Well, he only goes half. That tends to make me think he's got like ace, jack, ace, queen. This guy is going to go away. Anybody that calls a raise and then checks usually is weak. Usually. Especially from the blind. This is going to be a fold. There's a new study group as well. You can join the study group that we have for poker folks, poker players at Positive Poker Insiders Study Group. We have that on Facebook and on Skype. And if you want to join, you can send us an email and ask to join that. Provide your Skype name. And there's a lot of discussions going on in there. And hopefully there'll be some videos to watch and to comment on and things like that. Maybe we can get a private game going where it's just everybody on Skype and we can talk about the hands and we can agree to do that without revealing anything during the hand, but just after it. It's always entertaining to do that. You can check my playlist there on YouTube. Just search Al Spath or Positive Poker Insiders and you can see there's group Skype training videos there. There's over 200 videos that you can build a bankroll with the micro limits from 5 cent, 10 cent up to $1, $2, including tournaments. I've been doing a lot of tournaments lately over at True Poker, and I'm going to continue to do them this week. I got to get some six player regular. I don't like to do the turbos too much. One, it doesn't match with my game because I have the patience and discipline to wait for hands and let other people knock each other out. And two, it doesn't give you a lot of time to cover as many hands and teach what you need to teach during a session. And so I prefer to do the other way and do the regular. It'd be nice if they, I don't know if anybody could tell me if they have any double ups over there. If they have double ups over there, I would love to do some double ups too. Just show people how they can just double their money by getting into the top three. In other words, if it's a six player table, you just have to finish top three and you get double your entry. That's all you get. And if you get, you know, a 10 player table, you just have to get into the top five. What it does, it's not a great way to build a bankroll, but what it is, it's a great way to get you to show a lot more patience and discipline to get down to where you're near the money spots, if the money spots were actually the top three or top two spots. So that's what they're designed to do, in my opinion, is to help a player not spend a lot of money, yet still be able to get a return for their money and learn as they play. Must go fishing. Ed is in the house. Welcome, Ed. Hope the broadcast is loud and clear, and hope you can see that I have Posse's favorite hat on today. Let me see if I can get it up close so you can read it. Yep, that says dead money. He's been doing great, folks. He's been doing great in the coaching apprentice program, and he's been killing it here at Full Flush, especially at 25 cent 50. He's really racked up a couple $1,000 worth of wins this last 2 weeks, and if you check him out right now, those that are live, and just go see if he's in a six player table, I guarantee you he's probably $100 up at this point, sitting with 50 and running it up. He's got a good beat on his opponents, and he feels, and I do too, that the opponents here, usually in these smaller ponds, in other words, sites that don't have as many people. Oh, he's getting crushed by sixes here. Don't have the experienced players that you do in a big place like Poker Stars or True or ACR or any of those sites. So, you know, he's really making hay here. And I say that's an old term, but that's, you know, making money and making the best of things. And hopefully he'll withdraw at least $1,000 as soon as he can, because, you know, I just don't know about the site and payouts recently. I know that Ronster got his money. He got $1,000 the other day, which I'm thankful for, which is good. One guy that I was training, he decided it was enough. He couldn't win here. So he's going to stick to live play. So he doesn't need any money to play here on the table, unfortunately. So I know there was somebody asking Posse the other day at the table that he had money to get rid of that he didn't want to withdraw. I don't know who that was, but you can put him in touch with me. I can try to help him out a little bit, Ryan. Oh, pocket aces for slot play. Well, queen three and the... I'm being very quiet at the table, but you've seen the cards. So it's my turn to get the crap. Everybody else has had them, and I've had some pretty decent cards, so... Welcome, Monroe 97. Where are you from? And how'd you find us, bud? What's your name? So we can give you a shout-out on this video that I'm recording that'll go up on YouTube and make you a star, man. Let's hear your story. Monroe, here we go. We got 27 from slot play, all in with maybe pocket queens against the ace queen. It's aces again, back-to-back aces. Here we go, folks. And only a 10 could have saved proc. Woo! Now that's doubling up, folks. That seat's been horrible. Horrible! Let's see how this guy does from Tampa. Nice double up, slotty. Slutty slotty. I mean, no, I shouldn't say. Uh-oh. A $6 bet from Posse. I'm going to say that Posse really had pocket tens or jacks there. Let's wait and see from Posse then. I apologize for my voice. What? Thrown around at this 10 cent 25 cent table today. A lot of people gone broke. You got four people over 30 bucks at the table. 25 to sit is the max, so you know that the 56 and the 52 and the 40 have all won money. I don't think they've reloaded many times. There's a low end of a straight for Wilson. I might limp here if Posse doesn't raise. If he raises, of course, I'm throwing away. It's not that great a hand. But what did he raise here with? He has two limpers, and he only made it a dollar. He wants action. So I would think that he probably has maybe king, queen, suited, ace, jack. So let's assume that he has that. We got check, check. He'll bet in here a round 270. 250, okay. Boo! Booyah! Somebody hit a set or two pair. Weebs put all his money in. Posse got out of there faster than Weebs got in there. So, show us Weebs. Show us Weebs. The only thing everybody needs to know about Weebs is it says he's an asswipe. Destroy him and his comments. He's usually one of these guys that just comments over here in the chat. And he's a real dick. Tracy, you know what I mean. Wow, Posse says he had ace six of hearts on the one that he bet $6 against Nasir. I knew it was weaker pair, but I didn't think it was a weaker ace. Could play it, won it. A lot of times at these tables, you can win some hands based on opponent's stack sizes. So it's always important. Earlier in the match, Posse made a mistake on one because he didn't notice, I think it might have even been Nasir, that he only had X amount of, he could have called a bet and maybe won the hand. But then, of course, Nasir is going to back it up and say, oh, it was a good fold. But sometimes you got to look because it might be just worth the call because you can't lose any more money than, you know, a dollar or so. So keep track of it. You know that this guy is a shorty here. Queen nine would have hit two pair. I'm not usually inclined this far away from the button. I could have been first in for a raise here, yes. And I would have raised, but if I would have been maybe one or two slots over, I might have done it, but not three to go. It's just not my wheelhouse. I know it's in some of your wheelhouses, but that's okay. Everybody has different standards and everybody has different choices. Now, I can't tell the font size this morning, so Posse, help me out. Does the font size of chat, has it gone back to small again? If it does, I need to know how to change that because I'm unaware. Thank you very much for the assistance. I don't think Nasir has the spade. I don't think he bets the spade there unless he's got maybe a 10 of spades. Posse going up the dollar. Nope. limping with my pairs today, letting other people put money into the pot. I'm not trying to scare anybody away. That's exactly what I'm doing. The only way this helps me is if everybody checks and a five rolls off. I think Wilson will bet the queen. I'll take one card for a quarter. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Did that get me in trouble? Does that guy really have the jack queens? He goes up to a dollar. I'm going to go to 375. And the Sears is going to push it all in. Sorry, Nasir. Ba, 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 ba. You heard it here first, and $50 is reached. Okay, folks. Now we got to get to 65. We keep adjusting. Poor Nasir. Told you, if they didn't get me out of there for a quarter, I was taking that five to roll off. Perfect setup for the person with the jack. Person with the jack, with a jack, queen board, got to be thinking, what do other people have? They could have the queen, sure, but they could have king 10, they could have 10, 9. There's a lot of draws on the board, you know. There's just pocket pairs that people can have, sure. So you got to put more than a quarter in that pot. Cards again can be like white watching paint dry. It could be boring, but hopefully when I do play it, I make it interesting for you. And when I'm not playing, I hope I make it interesting for you on what other people are betting and what they might have. Again, here's a limper. This guy Nasir, he came right back and he posted. He actually changed names. That's a different Nasir. It's probably the same guy. He's got two counts. I can't answer anybody's Skype at this time because I didn't change the view of it, and if I bring it up, it's going to block my image, so I can't bring the Skype up at this time. Somebody's trying to Skype me right now. All right, Jack, Posse, Jack. Posse, Jack, Jack. Queen, Jack. Queen, Jack, betting. No doubter. Ed, hope things are going good for you. Must go fishing. Try to do a few more of these $10 challenge tables this week. A lot of people seem to like them, and it forces me to play tighter and smarter as well. That's the second time this guy has pushed. Last time he had ace queen. Do you remember that? He went all in against the aces, I think it was. Let's see right now if Nasir chunks it in there. Ace queen again against pocket aces. And there's no hope for the Woody. He was happy to get the money in that time. Back to raising. This is a all in. Re-raise. Let's see what Posse. I didn't think Posse wanted to get involved in that. And Posse was shoving with pocket sevens or something. I wonder what pop with what. I say sevens or eights. Let's see. wins is going to lose. The goal is to wait and get your money in good. What does that mean? It means get yourself in the pots and you have good cards and you're ahead. Three queens, that's a full boat. Oh, good, he reloaded. Folks, we've got a man that's got money. We owe you love that. He's asking for a $20 bill from Posse for doing him that favor. King of Diamonds. Thank you, Ed. Thank you. Happy Easter to everybody out there. When I finally caught up and passed Posse, I didn't know if I could catch him when I was at 10 and he was at 60. I think what happens to Ryan when he plays these tables, he tries to play them similar to his 25 cent 56 player tables, and the tactics that he uses don't work here as well with so many calling stations. And he wins hands, but then he goes a roller coaster and he loses hands. So this isn't his wheelhouse. To me, the 10 player table, I've told him already on screen, and other pieces people have told him, his is a shorthanded table. His is a isolate, dominate type situation for him. He's very, very good at that. And being that he's so young and good looking, as the girls say, he's got more time to learn different things about the game, and that's what he's doing. He admits it just like I do. And I'm 67 years old, still learning. Can't get cards to play. If you guys are playing these cards, you're probably leaking money. Here comes a dollar bet. Nope, he was typing. Al Cavalls is in the house. I don't know where he's in from, but thank you. I hope you'll follow us here on Twitch. This is a challenge table today. I started with $10. The goal was $35. Then the goal was $50. Now the goal is $65. A lot of people say, you know, you get suited connectors or you get connectors, you got to get in hands because they make a lot of money. I say that too. But you got to know when to put money in the pot, from what position. You can't just keep leaking money off all the time. You've got to be able to increase that bankroll. again, there's a lot of folks out there that play any two suited cards. It is not correct to do that. Gonna do a roast pork loin today for Easter. Don't know what your plans are. But if you're in the area, come by, slice you off some. When you come to the fork in the road, take it. Caval's asked how to win with ace ace, I lose with king king. Hi, how to win with ace ace, I lose versus king king. Yeah, okay. You know, Caval's has got a great point there. I it just seems that ace ace against king king in some races, it doesn't seem fair that the kings spike a king with only two outs in the deck. They come up winning, or they make a flush or something like that. I think it goes back, Caval, to really pre-flop, and a lot of times pre-flop, there's nothing you can do against kings or queens. They're not going to get, you know, they're going to put the money in. You're going to put the money in. What are you going to do if you flop comes with a king or a queen and you've got the aces? You're not going away because you're not giving the credit for the other guy having pocket queens or pocket kings. In most cases, you're putting them on ace king or ace queen, so you're going to lose your money. It's sometimes it's just the R, what they call the RNG, the random number generator. And this site, for instance, has a lot of people seem like sucking out. True Poker, I've been playing over there recently, and man, their rivers are just horrendously dangerous. I'd like to see how you play them, Caval, in real life. Where do you play and what limits do you play? Do you play in cash games or do you play in tournaments with that? So I picked up a really good hand, but I'm, you know, out of position being, I'm not going to let Posse limp. I'm not going to let him, well, if he raises me, I might just flat him. No, I can't do that. He can't do that. He should bet now. Put the pressure on me. Still want the image of the table. I'm playing sweet ass cards, even though I didn't hit nothing there. I'll call for 15 cents here. Oh, those could have been two eights instead of two sevens. I think we'll get a dollar bet here. Or nothing. Wow. Here comes something. No, don't tell me this eight's going to win the pot. Let's put a quarter out and see if anybody thinks I got a seven. I'm slow playing. He bets or raises, he's got the sevens. I'll take the money. Money talks, bullshit walks. Caval's is saying, I don't think I need to go all in before the flop. Don't. Why wouldn't you want to go all in if you got somebody to call you every single time you have aces? If you know that someone's going to call you all in, if you got all, the best hand and they only have two outs, you want to get your money in all the time. But if you're going to kowtow to making a raise with aces, somebody re-raising you and you calling them instead of re-raising them again, and then seeing a flop and then being afraid of any queen, jack, or king hits the board because you think they got a set. You know, you're going to lose a lot of tournaments. So, I think I'd like to see you bet. I like to see you in a sit and go situation. I hope you checked out some of my videos recently that I've done on sit and goes and seen how I play those aces. Flatting this guy in an early position to Zier. Very interesting. What would Posse have, possibly? Maybe pocket fours? Pocket threes? I think he'll bet here since nobody bet. And he'll try to bet higher, closer to $3 to take it right now with a smaller pair. I needed two big blinds, but opponent raised to sexy sound. What? I don't know what he meant there. Posse gets two callers who checked, who are out of position. So they don't believe he's got what he says, or he doesn't have very much. So now he's going to have to make a $6 bet to get them out. That two does not help them. And he checks it on the turn. Does he call with sevens? If he had sevens. Nines is, oh, he's got king 10. He got himself paid off. Pretty good. And he's back in front of Al again. $59.43. Hey, soft top 6-6 is in the house. Hope to be seeing a recording of him later on this week. Again, this has been a $10 challenge. Sit at the 10 cent, 25 cent table and try to get to 35. We did that. Then we tried to get to 50. We did that. Now we're trying to get to 65. All with the $10 we sat with. So, table's been pretty good so far. Thank you, everybody, for coming by this morning. Checking in. Oh, I got no spades. I got no hit on the nine. No hit on the ace. I got three callers. There's no sense in putting any more money into this pot. I'm going to make him think I'm going to take a little time here. Make him think I... Gee, I don't think that 10 could hit somebody else better than hit me. I just can't play it. It's nothing for me to try to steal here against three opponents. Any of them that hits a 10 at the end is going to call me. So why would I try to bluff a pot like that? Ace 10 here? Oh, says he has the hearts. Little tricky guy, a little tricky. I wasn't putting more money into that pot. This is an easy fold. Nigel is from the UK, and I believe it's, oh, he's got like a month or so, maybe 2 months to go before he goes to his annual jaunt to downtown Las Vegas, Nevada. We'll kick some ass and take some names and boot scoot around with his excellent machine that the casino makes available to him for transportation. I just don't know how he does it sometimes. He's has to take a 10 to 12 hour flight from the UK all the way to Vegas. Sometimes it's a stopover, but a lot of times it's straight through. But man, it's a lot of seat, a lot of sitting time. I just can't do it. Yeah, we're coming up on, well, we only got 45. We've got another 15 minutes before we get an hour in, so that's good. But in actuality, I sat down 20 minutes, let me check my clock, 25 minutes prior, so I'm just over an hour right now, to be honest about the thing. But and when I came on, the first hand you saw me, I had aces. Just happened to come up as I did the OBS, and I got it up after everybody else had bet, just come around to me, in fact. I'd love to see the flop with this without having to put any money in. Come on, Posse. Limp, 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 limp. Don't be silly and go $1.25. This guy has got no sense of humor at all. When he hears that, he'll start laughing. We have about a minute and 50 delay. Well, he's going to go half. He's been playing half pot. So 325 is what I think he's going to go here. And that would be a check. Nigel says he's got 6 weeks and 5 days before he's in Vegas land. Good for you, Nigel. Next time, Nigel, think of this way. Stop over in Baltimore. I'll pick you up, and we'll take you to Maryland Live, which is a great casino. And you can play on the way to Vegas or on the way back from Vegas. 15 cents, I'm not even going to put it in the pot with the 2-7. I know I could hit it 2 and 7. I get 2 2s and stuff like that. But this is really crap. I'm trying not to give away money this morning, folks. I'm trying to show you that, you know, sometimes you just have to tighten up. Even I have to tighten up. Because I try to demonstrate so many things that are a little on the looser side because of position. Trying to show you, trying to stretch you, trying to get that rubber band to stretch out so that when the rubber band collapses, you're a little bit bigger than you were before you started with that rubber band. Maybe you'll be a little bit more aggressive, a little looser. Not so much. And Nigel says it's 10.5 on a direct flight going into Las Vegas. Lost Wages, Nevada. I don't know if Ryan is going to stream. He streamed a couple times yesterday, and today's Eastern, so I'm going to stream until 12:15 today, which is about 11 more minutes. So maybe once around the table, maybe a little bit more than that. I'm not sure. Depends on how fast the table goes. Keep getting cards like that. It'll be real fast. I do appreciate everybody that comments up at on YouTube. Mr. Daly, and it really is impressive to see so many people watch so many videos and learn so much for free. If they had to pay for a coach, it would be a lot of money for the investment that they're putting into learning how to play this game. I want to thank all those that donate to the stream for helping us put the stream up. That's the only way we make money on a stream is donation. And that can be made at AlSpath at AlSpath.com on PayPal. And we certainly appreciate that so very much. And I'll continue to do the free videos, no matter if I get donations or not. I just want you to know that. Now, Nasir put a quarter in. I'm not going to raise here because he's I'm looking at the money behind. I talked about this before. He's really looking to jam with some good cards, and I don't want to jam with the nines here unless I flop a nine. There it is. So here we go, folks. We've got a very coordinated board. A pot is 150. I'm going to go $4 and see if 8 wants to come with me. No. I wasn't going to give anybody a chance to get a straight on me there without paying a good price. So we're going to go up the pot. The pot's not big enough. We're going 150 at this table. I wanted him to push in there with the 426. I'll take that matchup. There's a loose guy. I'm going to check this back at him. I don't think there's any way he has the king there. But I have nothing. Here's a limp. I don't normally limp with these cards, but at this table, it's been paying off for me. Just trying to see flops and flop something good. The sear is the 50 cent better. Whoa, $2 from Patango from South Bend, Indiana, home of Notre Dame. Who are playing, I believe, Kentucky tonight for a spot in the Final Four. Well, I made it around the table and it ain't 12:15, so I guess I'll take another loop around the table and see what's happening. Take the auto put. Oh, Posse just left. Took his profits. Good. Good for him. Hope you got the check earlier this week, Ryan. Go ahead. Take it. This will be my last auto post. Decent cards, not great, but 8-hander now. Remember, Nasir might jam, so let him jam. Danko was a quick call. Top pair here. Love to have him have king jack, but nope. I need two more callers. Come on, at least one more caller. Let's see if... Oh, that's not a caller. I didn't get an answer from Ryan whether or not he was going to stream this afternoon or any time. I know it's Eastern. He's got his family, so I don't think so. But if he is, he's welcome to do it. I only got less than 5 minutes left, and I'll be calling it a session, and hopefully... Many people will watch this video more than one time and learn from it. Suited cards. I could limp here, but not worth it in this hand. 5 minutes of the big blind, whatever comes first, folks. Remember, there's about a 2 minute delay, so after I do finish, don't go away until the very end. And next week, Sunday conversation will be Noah Schwartz. You all know him from TV, and you know him from World Series of Poker. Should be a great interview, I hope. And then Rich Muni from the Players Poker Players Alliance will be on the following Sunday. Rich is a great guy, and that'll be a great conversation. So if you got questions about legalized poker and what's going on, and who's testifying, and how they pick people to testify, then you need to listen into that broadcast, or at least tell some folks. And Posse is going to be done for Easter, meal with the family, five tables this morning, 3 hours of play, up 160. That's a great day. That's a great way to earn a living. That's pretty good. Right? So, 3 hours at the 160. Think that's, you know, you're getting almost $55 an hour. $55 an hour. If you did that 6 hours a day, that's three something a day. Even at three something a day, 5 days a week, that's $1,500. That's $4,500 a month. Come on, that's a good salary. Except he doesn't know math. His win rate, he said, was $80 an hour. It's not $80 an hour. $60 an hour, Ryan. You said you did 3 hours. All right, nothing here. Well, anyhow, we did really good. We started with 10. We ended with, or we got one more hand, looks like, to go. We ended around 58, so we made about six times our money. So that's worth the challenge table today. Although it was a challenge table, somebody asked me to do it. They didn't bet me. Normally, they bet me if I can get to a certain amount in an hour, they'll pay me X amount of money on top. And if I don't, I have to pay them $10 or something. I didn't do that today. I just did a challenge table to challenge myself and to just broadcast it, stream it live, no editing, as always, and see how things turned out. He's going to opt out here, I think. No, he doesn't, but I am. My name is Al Spath. I thank you today for watching on Positive Poker Insiders. I hope you'll follow us there. We've got some great interviews coming up. We've got streaming. We've got Dave Romer, lead instructor over at Poker School Online, the Lango, and we got Posse 1972, also going to be streaming this week. So check us all out. It's been great, and happy Easter, everybody.